to send a big thank you out to Love's Truck Stop for allowing me to camp in their parking lot.
Okay, we're at Love's Truck Stop here. Everybody loves love. Am I right? Everybody loves love? All right, here we go. All together now.
All you need is love.
All you need is loves. Loves is all you need.
If I don't get that on YouTube or TikTok later, I'm going to be upset.
This is for all my musician friends or anybody else who knows what Muscle Shoals is.
Okay, hey, it's me again, and I'm just pulling into Muscle Shoals. If you don't know what Muscle Shoals is, follow me.
Fortunately, me and my buddy were the only two taking the tour that day. And the tour guides were passionate about the history of Muscle Shoals.
There were several things that made this studio so successful. You had the greatest musicians in the world with the Swampers. This was a dry county, so when artists would come here, they could really focus up and just work on the music. You know, the Stones did 3 songs in 3 days. Brown Sugar, Wild Horses, and You Gotta Move. And also, it was cheaper than LA and New York.
Mostly, I imagine the sound, though.
And the room's the greatest sounding room in America, or in the world.
David Hood, okay. Bass player.
He's one of the Swampers.
He's the bass player for the Swampers. This man right here, his name is Eddie Hinton. Phenomenal songwriter. Wilson Pickett, Etta James, everybody.
Wow.
He wrote that song, Bobby Womack, You Don't Know Love Until You've Had a Real Good Lover.
No problem.
That's Jimmy Johnson. He was the engineer here. He was one of the main driving forces. He was one of the Swampers. He played guitar. This man right here, that's Arif Mardin. He worked for Atlantic, was a big time producer.
He was a producer?
Yeah.
Okay, gotcha.
Of course, that's Sonny, like I said.
Oh, yeah.
When Sonny was here, they made him leave. He was getting on everybody's nerves. Roger Hawkins right here.
He's your drummer?
Yes, sir.
Was he considered a Swamper then?
Yeah.
Okay.
Him, David, Jimmy, Roger, and Barry. David is the only one alive, sadly. That's Jerry Wexler.
Okay.
He was the vice president. Well, he passed away in 2008. And he's the one that signed Aretha, Records, the Stones. He's the one that brought all these guys here. He's also the one that loaned them the money to open the studio. $18,000.
Wow.
This is Barry. He played piano and keys. Phenomenal keyboard player. This is a backup singer named Jeannie Green. I know she sung on probably the Paul Simon stuff, Cher stuff. She sung on the Willie Nelson, the stages here. This lady right here, that's Donna Godshaw. She was in The Grateful Dead. And that's Tom Dowd, probably the greatest engineer of all time. He's the one that engineered the Fillmore East with the Allman Brothers. Layla. I mean, this picture's a who's a who of everybody great.
And there is
Cher.
Cher.
Yep. On the album cover, they actually had our address on a blue sign that they put on there. The boys liked it so much that they decided to put the sign on the front of the building.
It's out there to this day?
Yeah. Here's a great picture of Cher and Sonny.
Hang on. Out in front of the studio here? Yeah,
that's just some random guy that lived here. That's what makes the picture great, though.
Oh, my God. I'm in Muscle Shoals studio right now. Check this out. Check the sound. Hey! Hey! Woo! Hey, there's the shitter. Mick Jagger might have took a shit right there. There's my favorite room, the drum room. It's just like Nashville. They got one tom and a floor tom. That's every club in Nashville set up that same way.
Yeah, but Nashville don't have V3s and a Leslie.
Here's Leslie. Lovely B3. Dude, this is so cool. Rod Stewart.
That's Leonard Skinner.
Oh my gosh. In this studio.
They did 2 records here.
Yeah.
These are Jimmy Johnson of the Swampers.
These two right guitars. Here, Jimmy Johnson.
Yeah, the Telecasters are his.
Oh, wow.
This one belonged to Pete Carr, who was a big-time session musician in town. He played lick on Main Street, Bob Seger. That's all his guitar plays.
Main Street, recorded right here at Muscle Shoals. This is Bob.
A little bit.
Did Jerry Lee Lewis ever play this piano?
Not Jerry Lee Lewis, but maybe everybody else.
Like
Leon Russell, Bob Seger, Billy Powell, Leonard Skinner, right?
Oh my.
Among Lord. Others, the Swampers.
Hey, can I?
Rod Stewart. You can play it for a second, yeah.
Here. Chase, what about this Fender amp?
Deluxe Reverb.
Used by who?
Jimmy Johnson.
Oh, this is
and the Swampers, yeah.
This was Jimmy's.
Yeah, a lot of those guys use Fender amps, of course.
That's the vocal booth.
Vocal booth,
so
a lot of
people sang in there on these classic albums, and there's a photo of Linda Ronstadt singing in there.
Oh, 71. My gosh. That was in this room.
71.
And Cher was the first to use it, right?
Cher was the first to record here, and they hadn't yet built this nice booth
yet, okay.
In 69. You know, yeah. the Swampers played on a lot of big records, but they also did a lot of those songs that people remember but can't name the artist.
Right.
Luther Ingram sang in there. He did If Loving You Is Wrong, I Don't Want to Be Right.
Gotcha.
He sang that in there.
The Swampers were just hired then when somebody wanted to hire them. But when Skinner come in, they all played their own.
They all played. The Swampers engineered and produced a young Lynyrd Skynyrd.
So, hey, now I can say I sang at Muscle Shoals.
Yeah.
I sang at Muscle Shoals Studio. So cool.
Kept my cool, I ain't no
this was the first hit, the first big hit to come out of this studio.
So take a letter, Maria.
Played on this
keyboard. That's him 50 years ago recording I'll Take You There. Yeah, that's him. Oh my god. Well, Roger was a mean drummer, obviously.
And yeah.
He was played Kodachrome in there.
Willie Nelson did this song here with the Swampers in 73. Okay, this song right here. The Swampers recorded the music and then they pitched it to Bob Seger. This song right here. Guess the artist playing guitar. Dwayne Allman. Muscle Shoals actually hired him to come do studio sessions. Wasn't necessarily considered a Swamper, but he could have been. The Stones stuck into town. Three nights, wrote three songs. The room here didn't have all these private rooms at the time. So Mick recorded in this room. I'm in the control room of Muscle Shoals. I'm sure they didn't have this back then.
No, not that. Of course not. Everything else they do.
Oh my word.
What brand is this?
API.
Mm-hmm.
I'm here in Muscle Shoals Studio with one of the engineers for the soundboard, which you're looking at right here. My newest, bestest friend.
Chase Brandon.
Chase, mm-hmm. Who all have you run board for on this thing?
I've worked with the couple years I've been doing it. Hadn't been too long. I've learned a lot, but I've worked with the Allman Betts Band.
Oh, my God.
Was that Dickie Betts?
Dickie Betts' son.
Son.
Devin Allman, Greg Allman's son. I've worked on their records as an engineer, assistant engineer, and that was a great time. Learned a lot. And Nicole Atkins, who's a great artist.
Somewhere down the line, Chet Atkins?
No relation to Chet. But she's been a prominent artist for years and makes a lot of good kind of indie rock records. And
I've
worked with her on a couple occasions and worked on the Rival Sons album.
Right.
It's been...
And this studio is still active, correct?
And
available. So, I mean, like, what would it take to record in this series?
Recording? I mean, for us, it's, we have a website and we have contact information and inquiries to be able to get in touch with us. And we don't book every single session that comes our way, but we want to...
We
want to look it over and want a submission. It's more of a submission.
I see.
Project proposal based thing, and we look it over and
we still got one Swamper available, and he does still play sessions.
He does,
and he's 78 years old.
78, David Hood, looking good and just as good as ever, right? He still plays bass a whole lot,
and so as long as he's still alive, breathing, and picking, you can get him on your album.
I might not. He probably doesn't have time for every single person. Because he's David Hood, and
he'd have to be inspired.
Yeah, he'd have to be 10 of them, 20 of them, right? You sure can. I mean, he still plays on a lot of projects and gigs in town, and so it's pretty inspiring to see.
I appreciate that. You've been helping us out a whole lot here, brother. Thank you.
Thank you all. It's been great.
Thank you. I had to stop at one more historical place just blocks away from Muscle Shoals. You'll never guess whose house I'm walking up to. Helen Keller's. Take a good look at it. You see it? Because I'm sure she didn't.